Welcome to Whiteboard Programming, where we simplify programming with easy to understand whiteboard videos. And today I'll be sharing with you the types of cloud storage alongside their meaning, individual advantages and disadvantages they offer. So let's get started. When considering storing data in the cloud, you have three main cloud types available to choose from. The first one being block storage, which is a technology primarily used for storing data files in cloud-based storage environments or on storage area networks, also called as SANs. In the cloud, it is typically implemented through the attachment of a virtual disk to a cloud-based virtual machine. To state the least, block storage uses the process of breaking data into individual blocks, which can then be stored as individual pieces. Each data block is given a unique identifier, which further allows the storage system to place the smaller pieces of data in the most efficient location. And here, the approach itself involves storing blocks across different systems, with each block configured or partitioned to work with a different operating system. This means that blocks of the same original data can be stored in both a Linux environment and a Windows unit as well. Further, by decoupling data from your user environment, block storage allows the data to be spread across multiple environments. In creating such multiple paths to the data, the process of retrieving data is accelerated. So here, if you or an application request data from a block storage system, the data is retrieved and reassembled by the underlying storage system before being presented back to you. Also, block storage is a popular choice in modern data centers due to the advantages it offers, like high performance, scalability, ease of file modification, and operating system bootability. But similarly, it does have its drawbacks as well, which includes issues related to server binding, metadata limitations, and higher cost. Some of the major use cases for block storage include building transactional databases, email servers, and virtual machine file system or VMFS volumes. Next on the list, number 2, object storage, or also known as object-based storage, is a process that involves splitting data files into individual chunks known as objects. These objects are further stored in a single self-contained repository and can be distributed across multiple cloud-based servers and networked systems. Here, each object is given a unique identifier which can be used by applications to identify and retrieve objects when stored across a distributed system. Also, metadata is attached to each object which contains important information. This further can be extremely detailed and can include information like object size, date last modified, media type, and access rights. Also, the flat structure of the object storage makes it efficient to store large quantities of data, and it is also possible to store any kind of data with it, be it photos, videos, and log files as objects. Further, a few of the major advantages of object storage include reduced complexity, ease of searchability, resiliency, and cost efficiency. But similarly, object storage disadvantages include no locking mechanism, inability to use object storage services to back a traditional database. Operating systems can't easily mount an object storage like a normal disk. And in addition, object storage tends to be the least well-performing of all storage modes because of the heavier metadata overheads. Some of the major use cases of object storage include building IoT data management systems, disaster recovery storage, data analytics, and video surveillance. Next, number 3, file storage. So, file storage in the cloud is a hierarchical approach to storing data and is also known as file level or file based storage. This process involves storing data in files, and then these files are arranged in folders, which can then be organized into directories and subdirectories. For users and applications to locate and retrieve a file, they will need to know the pathway from the directory all the way through to the folder and the specific file. This information is included in a set amount of metadata that is attached to the file. To state further, file storage has a range of capabilities and can store almost any type of data. And just like with any computer, you can store a range of complex files and it's fairly quick for you to navigate as well. It is also very easy to configure, wherein you can control access to files with user rights, file locking and other controls. And if seen from a technical approach, hierarchical file storage performs well to a point. But do note that once your file storage gets to a certain size, you will begin to experience performance issues with a slowdown in file retrieval. This is caused by the constraints of only having a single pathway to each file, which only continues to increase as more folders, directories, and subdirectories are added to the system. But don't worry, by the way. Here, the nature of cloud system will allow you to mitigate these performance issues to a certain extent. Scaling too with file storage systems includes adding higher capacity virtual machines with additional compute power. Though you may find it less efficient and more expensive than if you were to instead opt for an object or block storage approach for your system. Some of the major use cases for file storage include building financial modeling systems, machine learning, application migrations, and running web content management infrastructure. Lastly, if you're wondering which cloud storage type you should use, well, let me tell you that the type of storage selected affects the cost of the storage and how easily you can access the data in the future. Organizations must account for factors like cost, scalability, retrievability, security, data volumes, and ease of management when choosing any of the cloud storage types for their use case. Further, as new data types and use cases arise, organizations must constantly evaluate and optimize their storage types for each subset of data. And accordingly, storage strategies and decisions should continually evolve as business needs and technology changes. With that, I hope this video was helpful to you and served value. If you love my content, feel free to smash that like button. And if you haven't already subscribed to my channel, please do, as it keeps me motivated and helps me create more content like this for you.